It is time to go on the road again, as we do each and every Friday of the summer. And this weekend's one of New England's longest running outdoor art festivals is kicking off right here in Rhode Island. Michaela wanted to scope it out. Let's take a quick look at her adventure getting down there.
That was a quick pickup, Sandra. I was able to track you on my phone.
Great.
I love Uber.
I do too.
Ladies Uber, right?
Yeah.
Ladies Day in Uber. I like to sing. Is that okay?
That's great.
I love singing in the car. We're taking an Uber on the road. Don't know where we're gonna go. Hit it, Sandra.
We're taking an Uber down the road. We don't know where we're gonna go.
Yeah, take it right up here. You know, you can ride an Uber for free up to $20 using the promo code The Road Show. Come along with us on the road.
Nice jam. Going to be singing that all day, and it looks like they got over to Wickford already. So let's check in with her now over at the historic Wickford Village. Good morning, Michaela.
Hey, good morning, guys. I'll tell you what, we had a fun drive down here, and we're so excited because the Wickford Art Festival is this weekend. So we're here with the festival director, Alex Johnson, and Kyle, too. We're going to get to you in just a second. He won a huge scholarship, which we will tell you all about. But first of all, Alex, you guys have been going through a lot of planning and preparation
Yes.
for this.
Yes, we have.
Just how long does it take to put together an event like this? The 54th, you said?
Yeah, it's the 54th. We started in January. Applications start rolling in at that time. And then in April, we start jurying the artists. And then once that's all selected, it's game time getting everything planned.
And it's a lot of fun down here, a lot of tents, a lot to see.
Yes, we have over 200 artists that are in the festival this year.
And a big part of it, in addition to not only you can come down here, check out some art, buy some art that you can take home, but you can help students in need. Tell us about the scholarship program.
So we have this scholarship raffle program where the festival artists and association artists, they donate work. And then during the festival, we have raffle tickets for sale for $2, and people can buy the raffle tickets and win the art. All the proceeds for the raffle go towards the scholarship.
And you said that it goes to a couple different students, right? Kind of varying in, mm-hmm. in different increments.
We have top three, and then we have a director's award. Mm-hmm. Kyle actually was our first place winner, so he got the biggest scholarship.
Congratulations, Kyle. Tell us about, yeah, give me five. I'll take a high five. Tell us about what type of art that it is that you do.
I like doing graphite, so it's a realistic kind of drawing. It's more detail orientated.
And you like to focus on a certain hobby in particular that a lot of people love.
Yes, I have a passion for skateboarding, so I try to include that in my art because it's something I love to do.
And how is this scholarship going to help you? Where are you going to school next year?
I'm going to the New School of Parsons. It's in Manhattan, right in the city, and I'm going to use it towards getting more art supply to help me further be able to art.
Yeah, and you were telling me too, Alex, that Kyle not only won the scholarship, but he's taking part in the festival.
Yep. He and another one of our winners is they have their own booth at the festival, and they're going to be able to sell their art and get experience of being a professional artist.
Well, you mentioned that so many artists have come into town for the festival. When does the fun kick off?
Tonight, it technically starts for the artists. We have our registration, and then we have an artist reception. And then tomorrow morning is when the festival begins for everybody.
All right. Well, good luck, Kyle. What an amazing opportunity. We're going to show you a little preview of some of that art and talk to a few artists, too, when we come back.
Earlier in the show, we checked in with Michaela, who is live right now over at Wickford Village, where the 54th annual Wickford Art Festival is about to kick off for a great display of more than 200 artists from around the world. Let's go back over to her to see how this event is shaping up for the beautiful weekend ahead. Hey, Michaela.
Hey, once again, you'll see a lot of variety here at the Wickford Art Festival throughout the entire weekend. You'll have painters, you'll have sculptors, you'll have photographers, and we're actually joined by two of them now. Dennis DeMora Jr. is one of them. Welcome. You said photography is something you've been doing for a while now.
Yeah, pretty much over 20, 25 years. It's something that is a passion, and it developed into being in gallery shows, so it's something that I really appreciate that I can share with people. Because doing nature and wildlife, I mean, I kind of look at it as, you know, nature, they did everything. I just happened to be there at the right time.
So tell us about the two pieces that you brought along right now. First of all, what kind of bird is that?
So this is a hummingbird, and I was very lucky to be able to get the hummingbird when it was perched. I mean, they move so fast.
They do.
So this could have been an hour of waiting for just the right time for him to relax or her to relax and just take a breath.
And that landscape is beautiful. Where in Rhode Island is that?
That's Lincoln Woods State Park. So that's a very... an awesome spot because a lot of things are happening there. It's, you know, part of the state. My daughter and I, Mia, go fishing there. So,
oh, very special.
And what's great is that's actually the first picture I've ever entered into the gallery here. And it just happened to be here. Yeah.
Well, excellent. Thank you so much. You can see he takes plenty of shots of nature during the day. Now, to someone who takes photos at night, that's when we want to turn to David Zapatka. Thank you so much for being here. Tell us about your photos and why you choose nighttime.
Well, nighttime photography is really an emerging genre for photography. The technology of the cameras have gotten so much better in the last 8 or 10 years that we can do this work now. And so I have here a couple pictures that the first one is right here in town. It's Plum Beach Lighthouse. I shot that a couple years ago. And it's really difficult to get stars and especially with the lights from the bridge. But
yeah.
It's something that I haven't quite perfected yet, but I'm very close. I do a lot of work like this. I've now shot 76 Northeast lighthouses. In fact, this picture right here is of Boston Light, which I shot last week. And
beautiful.
So that'll be on display as well at the art festival.
You mentioned how it does take a lot to kind of capture that moment when things are lit up at nighttime and possibly get the stars in the back. We just came off a 4th of July weekend, and a lot of people were trying to take the pictures of the fireworks,
right.
Which, you know, if you're just working off a smartphone or something, is really difficult to do. So having the right equipment when you're doing photography is really crucial.
Well, that's vital, and the work that I do is with the top-end DSLRs, so it's very expensive cameras, but you have to pick the right time. I only shoot during the new moon phase and clear skies and calm conditions, so if it's cloudy, I'm out of business that night.
Yeah, like you said, that the stars really do have to align to get the right photo. Are
That's
you excited
right.
to take part in the Wickford Art Festival?
I am. This is my second year, and it's great, and we hope that the weather forecasters are wrong, and that we're going to have great weather. That's what we're hoping for.
Well, the festival's going to happen no matter what. We have Dennis, we have David. There are so many other artists here as well. We're going to talk to two more when we come back.
For now, we want to send it back out one last time as Will chows down to Michaela, who's live in Wickford. Take it away.
Really good.
Thanks so much. I'm here now with an incredibly talented couple. Let's start with half of that couple, shall we? Daryl Harwood is here. Thank you so much for coming in here, because you're constantly on the move, constantly on the go. Tell us a little bit about what you and your husband do.
Well, my husband and I travel full-time around the country. We create our artwork mobily, and we live in our RV and pull a 16-foot trailer, and we do art shows all over the country.
Impressive. Some people need a whole studio. You're doing it on the road. Tell us about your piece here. It looks beautiful.
Thank you. It's acrylic and mixed media, and I build on wood luan quarter inch so I can create the nested box to hold the organic material. This piece is white birch. It's called The Breath of Spring.
And then did you treat that birch as well to blend
in? It is. Well, it's treated. It's lacquered, so it will stay permanently in just like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's kiln dried, so it's dried. It's not ever going to come apart. Yeah.
Beautiful. It's
Thank
a
you.
Really great piece. Thanks. And like we said, it's not just her. It's her and her husband. So we have to head on over to George. I'm going to cross by his piece very quickly. That way you can get a nice shot of that. Tell us what it is that you do. Slightly different than your wife there.
My work's a little different. My work's all hand-tooled copper.
Mm-hmm.
Worked with patinas to bring the colors in the copper out. And then it's burnished down and sealed. And I use organic elements that I collect as I travel around the country.
How are you able to do all of that in a trailer, like on the road?
I work outdoors on a sheet of plywood with nothing but hand tools.
Wow.
And I have torches, and you know, we just carry all of our tools with us.
Is this something that you've always done, that you've always been interested in, or did you play around with different medium before?
I'm a metal worker by trade. I did glass for 30 years. This is a new body of work for me within the last 3 years. It was created, prior to this, I did the metal with glass, mm-hmm. and I phased the glass out. I really enjoy the refineness of the metal with the softness of the organic elements.
Yeah, it's a beautiful combination. I told you, even just the beautiful color combination that you've selected there. A lot goes into making a piece like this.
There is. There's a lot of effort and a lot of work. Mm-hmm. All my pieces are sealed, so these, after I patina them, everything is sealed so that they're fine in bathrooms or outdoor covered areas. And mm-hmm. most of my pieces go vertical or horizontal.
Oh, that's good to know, too. So depending on what space you have in your own home, you can kind of mix and match, move mm-hmm. things around
Absolutely.
A little bit. Really must make it all worth it, though, when you come to a festival like Wickford Arts and you're able to provide that piece for someone.
It is. It is. It's really nice. A lot of times we'll go to people's homes and bring our artwork in just to make sure it works for them and their space. And,
wow.
You know, we just love to work with our clients and customers. We have a lot of collectors across the country as well.
You can tell you're both very passionate about what it is that you do. So one last look at both of those pieces. If you want to see them for yourself in person, along with those other photographs that you saw earlier and so much more, there is a lot to check out over at the Wickford Art Festival. It happens all weekend long.